Hello viewers, welcome to you all to my channel iCare Advisor. I hope you are having a good day. Today our topic of discussion is regarding the toric lenses transposition. Before, I have already made a video on the simple transposition, and many of my viewers and some of my students also requested me to make another video on the toric lens transposition. So I will show you in a very simple step how to do the toric transposition. Before that, I will just give my introductions. Myself, Shayan Mukherjee, optometrist, practicing for more than 11 years, and presently I am working in Dubai, Abu Dhabi. And one more thing, if you like this video, please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, and please share with the others also, so that also they can learn from this video. Basically, this is an educational video, so this will help all the persons to learn how to do the toric transposition. So without wasting any time, please follow and check how to do it. So we will now see the steps of the toric transposition. For the first step, the prescription of the cylinder and the base curves should be the same. This is the first step. Second step is the new spherical will be the old sphere minus the base curve of the sphere with sine. Third step is the base curve with opposite axis, and the new cylinder will be the base curve of the sphere plus cylinder. SPH is sphere, CYL means cylinder, and BC is the base curve. So for the toric transposition, it is the sphere, the new sphere is the sphere minus base curve, and the denominator base curve with opposite axis, and the base curve plus cylinder with axis. So for this one to understand in a better way, I will show you with some examples. Then it will be easy for you. So I will show you the first example. In the first example, I will be using plus 3, suppose, spherical with plus 1 diopter cylinder 90 degree axis. Okay, and for this case we will take the base curve as, for example, as minus 6 diopter. So here if we do this, what is the first step? The prescription cylinder and the base curve cylinder should be the same. So the prescription cylinder and base curve cylinder is not the same. So to make this, the first step, we have to do the simple transposition and change it to the minus cylinder. So if we do the simple transposition, what will be? The new sphere will be the plus 4, plus 3 plus 1, that is plus 4, and the axis sign will be changed, the cylindrical power will remain the same, and the axis will be plus 90 for this one, so it will be 180. So this is the new prescription based on which we will do the toric lens transposition. And here you can see that the base curve cylindrical sign and this sign is the same. For both these cases, the sign is the same. So now we will do this calculation in the next step. So what is the next step? We have to find out the new sphere. What is the new sphere? New sphere is equal to old sphere minus base curve sphere with sine. So what is the old sphere? That is plus 4 minus base curve sine with sphere. So it's minus 6. So the new sphere is equal to plus 4 minus minus, it will become plus. So it is plus 10 diopter. The second step is we have to change base curve with opposite axis. So the new one will be base curve is minus 6 and opposite axis, this is 180 degree. So we will change the axis to 90 degree. This is the second step. Now we will go to the third step, that is the new cylinder. What is the new cylinder? New cylinder is equal to base curve sphere, that means minus 6, plus the cylinder. We have to add this one. With the same axis. So this will be minus 6, this minus 1, which is equal to minus 7 diopter, and the axis will remain the same, that is 180 degree. So the new toric transposition, if we are doing the new toric transposition, value will be the numerator, we get it, the new sphere, this is the one, so it is plus 10 diopter. And the denominator is the base curve with opposite axis. This is the one first. And base curve plus cylinder with the axis, what we got? This is the one. So you can see the result. This is the first transposition example what we have done. I will give you another example and will make it more clearer for you. Now for the second cases, what we will take, this is the example number 2. We take suppose minus 3 with minus 1.50 90 degree axis, and the base curve we take as minus 6 in this case. Okay, so this case I will, you can see the base curve and this cylindrical prescription is the same. So no need to do a new transposition. We will directly follow the step number 1. The new sphere is equal to the old sphere minus the sphere of the base curve, which is equal to minus minus, it will become plus 6 minus 3. So the new sphere is equal to plus 3 diopter. Second step, what we are doing, the base curve with opposite axis. So it will be minus 6 into 180 degree axis. Third step, the new cylindrical power is equal to the base curve, that is minus 6, plus the cylinder, which is equal to minus 1.5. So the total cylindrical power from here, what we will get is minus 7.5, and the axis is the same for this, so it's 90 degree. So the toric transposition for this case, it will be the resultant one, it will be this plus 3, and denominator will be minus 6, 180 degree with minus 7.5, 90 degree. So I have given you two examples. I have shown you here. You can follow the examples and you can follow these rules. Once you memorize these rules, it will be very easy for you to do this transposition, toric transposition. And apart from that, if you have any queries, you can ask me through WhatsApp or you can comment me here. I will get back to you with this answer.